A year and 2 weeks after the revolutionary takeover in Marin, prison guards at San Quentin ruthlessly murdered George Jackson.
Saturday, August 21st, 1971.
Today at about 3 p.m., there was an attempted break from our adjustment center, which is our maximum security facility. Apparently, a gun was smuggled in and was in the possession of George Jackson. George Jackson was killed as he broke and ran outside the adjustment center.
We were allowed out by the fact that the control box had been opened.
Bato Talamantes.
And we all came out of our cells questioning what was going on. And at that time, we realized that the first floor tier of the adjustment center had in fact been seized by some revolutionary prisoners, one of them, George Jackson. That the skeleton crew that had worked on that Saturday, I think consisted of four officers, had been taken hostage and tied up and laid on the floor. And so it was pretty amazing in that very short period of time, which I call the half-hour revolution, when in fact prisoners did manage to overcome their captors and took over the cell block and for a few minutes tasted freedom.
I've been hungry too long, I've gotten angry too often, I've been lied to and insulted too many times. They pushed me over the line. From which there can be no retreat. If I leave here alive, I'll leave nothing behind. They'll never count me among the broken men.
Saturday, his life was cut short when he exited the adjustment center door, bolted past the forepost at San Quentin, which is your central control for the guards, and was sighted on and shot and killed by a sharpshooter guard, and he bled to death on the black asphalt